Hello viewers, today we are talk about Philip Pilsen Steer. Philip Steer, 1860-1942, was a permanent British painter, recognized for his contribution to Impressionism and landscape paintings. He was born on 28 December 1860. In England. His father, Philip Steer, was also an artist, which greatly influenced Philip's early interest in the art. Steer's formal education began at the Gaston School of Art, but he moved on to study at the South Kensington Drawing School in London. Unsatisfied with the British art scene, Steer sought further training in Paris, enrolling the prestigious Academia Julian and École d'Expox Art between 1882 and 1884. This exposure to French art, especially the works of Edouard Manet and the emerging Impressionist movement, had a lasting impact on Steer's style. In Paris, Steer became heavily influenced by French Impressionists like Claude Monet and Edgar Degas. Their focus on light, color, and natural setting resonated with him. Steer returned to England in 1884, where his style set him apart from many of his contemporaries who were still following more traditional art form. His early works were characterized by loose brush stroke, vibrant color scheme, and a focus on capturing the atmosphere of a scene rather than precise detail. Steer's formal education began at the Gloucester School of Art, but he moved on to study at the South Kensington Drawing School in London. Unsatisfied with the British art scenes, Steer sought further training in Paris, enrolling at the prestigious Academia Julian and École d'Expox Arts between 1882 and 1884. This exposure of French art, especially the works of Edouard Manet and the emerging Impressionism movement, had a lasting impact on Steer's style. In Paris, Steer became heavily influenced by French Impressionists like Claude Monet and Edgar Degas. Their focus on light, color, and natural setting resonated with him. Steer returned to England in 1884, where his style set him apart from many of his contemporaries who were still following more traditional art forms. His early works were characterized by loose brush strokes, vibrant color scheme, and a focus on capturing the atmosphere of a scene rather than precise detail. Steer gained recognition for his depiction of landscapes, seascapes, and beach scenes, particularly those from the English coastline, such as at Wells, Brunswick, and Southwold. His painting, The Beach at Philipsburg, 1889, is one of his most famous work, exemplifying his mastery of light and air. These seascapes become a hallmark of his career, reflecting the changing light of the English sky and coast. In addition to landscapes, Stravinsky's gifted portraits. He produced several remarkable works of figures in natural setting, often featuring women or children in relaxed, everyday poses. His paintings, Girls Running, 1889, capture the simplicity and beauty of fleeting moments. Although Stravinsky was closely allied with Impressionism, he was not limited by it. He blended various influences into his work, and his later career saw a shift toward a more restrained classical approach, moving away from the freer brushwork of his early career. He was also influenced by the old masters, especially J.M.W. Turner and John Constable. Two other great British landscapes artists, Turner's influence in particularly evident in Stier's later seascapes, which poses a scene of grandeur and subtlety. Stier's contribution to British art extended beyond his own paintings. He became a founding member of the New English Art Club in 1886, an organization formed in opposition to the Royal Academy's more traditional approach. They provided a platform for younger and more progressive artists, and Stiers was at the forefront of his movement. In addition to painting, Stier was a respected teacher. In 1893, he began teaching at the Slade School of Fine Arts in London, where he remained until 1930. Many of British future artists benefit from his guidance. Stier was not a strict teacher, but instead encouraged his students to develop their individual style and explore their creativity. His teaching had a profound impact on the development of British art in the early 20th century. Philip Wilson Stier continued to paint until his death in London on 18 March 1942 at the age of 81. Today, he is regarded as one of British most important late 19th and early 20th century painters. Bridging the gap between traditional landscapes art and modern Impressionism, his work is housed in many permanent museums, including the Tate Gallery in London. Stier's legacy is that of an artist who brought the fresh, experimental spirit of French Impressionism of British surrealism, while maintaining a deep respect for the tradition of British landscapes paintings. His ability to capture light, movement, and atmosphere continues to inspire artists and art lovers alike.